Good morning, children. Today, I am going to tell you a story from the great epic Mahabharat. Okay? So, listen the story carefully because at the end, I will ask you the questions but on the basis of the story. Okay? So, let's start the story. The King Pandu was the king of Hastinapur. He had 5 sons, Yudhishthir, Bhim, Arjun, Nakul and Sahadev, and all were known as Pandavas. Their cousin brothers means sons of Dhritarashtra. Yes, sons of Dhritarashtra, and they were known as Kauravas. Guru Dronacharya was their teacher. He taught them archery as well as sword fighting and fighting with spears and clubs. One day, Guru Dronacharya took the Pandavas into a forest. Look at the picture. What you can see? You are able to see that Guru Dronacharya is leading the boys and boys are following him. And all the boys are having arrows and bows with them, right? So, as a teacher, Guru must understand the ability of each and every student, right? So, how do the teacher can understand the ability of every student? Tell me. Yes, by taking a test. So, to take a test, what Guru did? He told. So, to take a test, Guru Dronacharya showed the students a bird. Yes, a bird sitting on a tree. And he told the students to aim at the bird's eye with their arrows, as you can see in the picture, right? After doing so, he asked the students, can you see the bird's eye? And what else can you see? So, one said that I can see the tree. Another said I can see the branch. And few of them told we can see the head of the bird. But can you tell me what Arjun said? Yes, Arjun was the only person who said that, sir, I can see nothing else but only the eye of the bird. Immediately, Guru Dronacharya understood that one day Arjun will become the great archer of the world. Why? Can you tell me why? Because his aim was perfect and clear, and he had a high concentration of power, better than others. Yes, he had a high concentration of power. So, Guru Dronacharya taught Arjun everything, whatever he knew. But children, there was another boy and his name was Eklavya. Yes, he was also very interested to learn archery from Guru Dronacharya. So he came to Dronacharya, but Dronacharya refused. Why? Can you tell me why? Because he was allowed only to teach the children of royal families. Yes, only the children of royal families. Then Eklavya became very sad. So what did he do? What does he did? Yes, he made the statue of Guru Dronacharya. Yes, he made the statue of Guru Dronacharya and regularly practiced archery in front of the statue. So, with his determination and hard work, he became the finest archer of the world. But when this came to the knowledge of Guru Dronacharya, he became very angry. He went to Eklavya and scolded him. He told that, how can you use my name and how can you make me as your guru? So he asked Eklavya to cut off his right thumb as a Guru Dakshina. Yes, he asked Eklavya to cut off his right thumb as a Guru Dakshina, as a prize. So ultimately, Arjun became the best archer of his time. So children, have you all heard the story carefully? Huh? So now I am going to ask you some questions. But before that, we will solve this puzzle. Are you all ready? Huh? So let's do it. Tell me, a person who teaches in an ashram is known as, can you tell me? Yes? Yes. The person who teaches in an ashram is known as Guru. So in column 1, you will write Guru. Right? Now, second, the art of shooting arrows. What is this known as? Archery. Yes. The art of shooting arrows is known as archery. Third one, the son of a king is known as, huh? Tell me. Yes, the son of the king is known as prince. And fourth one, a person who pays attention is known as attentive, right? And fifth one, the children who study are known as studious. Okay. Now, as I have told you in the beginning that I will ask you some questions, but on the basis of the story only. So are you all ready for it? Huh? So let's start it. Now, tell me, who was the guru of Pandavas? Who was the guru of Pandavas? Yes, Guru Dronacharya was the guru of Pandavas. And second question, what is the meaning of the word guru? It's a simple question. Yes? Yes. Guru means teacher, right? Third, what subject Dronacharya used to teach? You all know the answer. Yes. He used to teach archery as well as sword fighting and fighting with spears and clubs. Okay? Now, come to the next question. Did Dronacharya teach Eklavya really? No, he didn't. He didn't taught Eklavya. But Eklavya made the statue of Guru Dronacharya and he practiced archery in front of the statue, right? And because of this only, his determination and due to his concentration, he became the finest archer, right? And what is the last question? Why Guru thought that Arjun could be the best archer? Because Arjun's aim was clear and perfect. Yes. And he had a high power of concentration than others. And he was the only person among all of the students who was able to see the eye of the bird, right? And because of this, Guru Dronacharya understood that Arjun will become the best archer of the world, right? And because of this, he taught everything, whatever he knew to Arjun. Okay? So children, what have you learned from the story? Huh? Can you tell me? Okay, I will tell you. First is, your aim should be clear, right? And second thing, to do well in any subject, you should do hard work, but with honesty, as Eklavya did, right? Because of his honesty only and because of his determination only, he became the finest archer, right? And third one, yes, to do well in examination, first thing is that you should concentrate before answering to any question, as Arjun did, right? So, did you like the story? Yes, you liked it, na? So, let's call it a day, and till then, take care and study well, right? So, bye-bye and take care. God bless you.